Hello, friends. Have you ever gazed up into the night sky and wondered at the possibility of life on other planets? What marvelous beings might exist out there, hands extended in friendship, awaiting the moment when we humans take our first tentative steps into space? What tales will be told of that glorious day when we are first contacted by our brothers from beyond the stars?
Ah, you know, I've always been fascinated by the idea of an intelligent life, extraterrestrials, and all that science fiction shit. It's so fascinating to me, the idea that one day, we will come into contact with alien life. Alright, so the first problem right off the bat is this. It's the license. This is an E.T. game, and while it may not be directly related to the legendarily bad Atari game, it's still in the same heritage, so right away you know you're in for a treat. Let's just load the game up and start our interplanetary mission. Granted, loading on PS1 games was always pretty terrible, so I'll cut it some slack. Okay, nope! Remember that slack I just cut? Nope, I'm stitching it back together. Tape it. Look at the way the camera follows E.T., who, by the way, has never looked better. I don't even know if it's immediately apparent without playing it, but the camera movement is genuinely nauseating. So once you've taken a few aspirins and acclimated yourself to the camera, you learn what the game is actually about. You pick up plants? E.T. Interplanetary Mission, huh? More like E.T. into plants and shit. So yeah, you pick up plants in open doors mainly. You know, like the movie. You can also use telekinesis, but only on things a few feet in front of you, which, by the way, is the worst form of telekinesis in existence. It's essentially just having kind of long arms. Look at what I have to do just to get the objective to the destination. It looks like I'm trying to break the game. Whoa, E.T.'s got a stun attack? Awesome! Oh. Looks like he's just trying to get Wi-Fi or something. Now, you could probably guess just by looking at this, but the controls are pretty horrendous! And the graphics and art design aren't anything to take notice of either. Whoa, look at that run. When you lose health, you start to look like Michael Jackson, so plus one for realism. Look at that little jiggy does. So aside from all the boring, this game's pretty standard. Puzzles, collect things, open doors, fight grand wizards?
Now what the fuck are we supposed to do?